name's Christopher, the king of this castle. You've come at a very unusual time. You see, right now, I'm on vacation. Not that I need a vacation. It's for my sons. You see, Prince Richard and Prince Robert, they're typical boys. They love running and getting dirty and playing in the mud. But the thing is, they're not 5 and 6 years old. They're 21 and 22.
Where is the I'm soaked? I'm gonna get you!
You're not!
Not exactly what you would expect from royalty. Okay, so what's the big deal? They get a little carried away. Big deal is, it's like this all the time. It's always fun and games with them. They're never serious. You see, one day, they're going to inherit my throne and rule over the kingdom. But they're not ready for that kind of responsibility. Well, that's why I had this little experiment. I would go away and leave them in charge to see if that might open up their eyes. Doesn't look like it's doing a real good job, does it? Well, enter Sir Gavin, my oldest friend and most faithful knight. He's been in charge since I left, just to make sure that things don't get too out of control.
Thank you, sire. As always, it's a pleasure to serve you. And I am afraid that things haven't been moving as quickly as we had hoped.
No, we all got to see some of that.
Yes, and I was afraid of that.
Well, we can't give up, Sir Gavin. There's a cosmic battle between good and evil going on. And our enemy, Satan, would like nothing more than for us to give up in frustration. No, I believe God will bring something good out of the situation.
Yes, sire.
Well, I'm gonna go back to my vacation and you carry on, Sir Gavin.
I'll do my best.
Introduce everyone.
And fare thee well, sir. Well, you've all had a chance to meet Richard and Robert, so we'll just move on from there. Well, I see, here comes Ida. She's a matron of the castle. She's been with us a really long time. She does her best to keep things moving smoothly around here. Afternoon, Ida.
Oh, hello, Sir Gavin.
A beautiful day, isn't it?
Well, maybe for now, but that doesn't mean it won't probably turn to rain here soon.
Rain?
Or a thunderstorm, more likely.
Well, as I was saying, she's been with us a long time, and she does her best to keep things going smoothly, but Richard and Robert have been a real handful for her. Haven't they, Ida?
Did you say something?
I said the princes have really been a handful.
Ha! That's the understatement of the century. Now, I love those boys dearly. You know that. But I do try to tell them once what. Never does any good, though.
Well, maybe this little experiment of the king's will have an effect on them.
Yes, a terrible one. Meaning no disrespect, of course, but let's just hope our enemies don't hear about this.
Well, it looks like you found some beautiful flowers.
Well, I did, but they probably won't last long. I better get them in some water.
Oh.
Have a good afternoon.
Yes, indeed. Well, she's a likable gal, but she's somewhat of a party pooper. Yes. Well, we see, since the king has been gone, I come by the castle and spend a little bit of time with the princes. He's asked me to teach them a little bit about becoming a knight. You know, like sword fighting, bows and arrows, and how to ride a horse into battle, those sorts of things. But I don't think anything is really soaking in. So, well, we were on a hunt this morning, and so I'm going to go ahead and take it a little easy with them this afternoon. So I was thinking maybe I could have them bring Feed Flame. He's over here in the dragon chamber. Hey, Flame, you in there? Oh, well, it's just about dinner time. You must be getting pretty hungry. Ooh. Well, be patient, my friend. The reason we keep him in there, you see, is for For our safety, of course, but for his as well. See, when we found him, he was in really bad shape. So we brought him back here to nurse him back to health. Okay, be patient, we're coming.
I heard him roar. How bad is he?
Oh, he's really doing pretty good.
That's the spirit. Try to stay positive and look on the bright side of things. That's exactly what I do.
Oh, yes, you do.
Not sure it really does any good, though. So how much time does he have? Not long, I'm sure.
Oh, no, he's all right. He's fine. He was just getting a little impatient because I was speaking with the folks out there.
What folks? Where?
Well, the folks out there. Don't you see them?
I think you better come inside and lie down for a while.
No, I'm quite fine at it.
Are you sure?
Send the princes out. I'd like to show them how to play.
And I can just imagine what'll happen. They'll start some tomfoolery and then Flame will take a bite out of one. Well, you just tell those princes that if Flame bites their legs off, don't come running to me.
Well, I'm going to go ahead and get the food ready. We'll get the princes out here.
Sir Gavin, Ida said you wanted to see us.
Yes, yes, I do. I'd like to have you help me feed Flame.
You're kidding, right?
Well, no, why?
Well,
oh, don't be such a baby. I'm not scared of Flame.
Maybe we should just...
Nonsense. I'll be glad to help you feed Flame.
All right.
He just startles me, that's all.
All right, let's get the food in here. Richard, why don't you get some water?
What is that stuff?
Well, this is dragon chow with beef gravy.
I don't understand gravy.
All right, pour a little water in there. You see? Gravy.
Hey, that's cool. Let me try that.
All right, go ahead.
Cool. Dude, I'm glad I'm not a dragon.
Oh, be patient. All right, but you go ahead and carry that in. Set it down in front of me.
Are you sure it's safe?
He's not gonna hurt you. Go on, go on.
Oh, here goes. Hey, buddy, if I come in there, promise you won't eat me.
Oh, go on. Go on.
Was that a yes or a no?
Yes, all right. Sit in there.
Here you go.
Hey! He likes it.
He likes it. You know, he's sort of cute in a green, purple, scary, fire-breathing, flying dragon suit, but...
Oh, no! But we must take the war seriously and put on the armor that he's provided for us. Otherwise, we'll be exposed to the enemy. Right? Now, I want you guys to think about that, because someday you have to realize that life is not all fun and games all the time. And someday you will be responsible for protecting King's Manor. And that's a serious job. Now, I want you to think about that, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. See ya. Wow. You're serious. Yeah. He was.
Tomorrow.